Fellow compatriots, my name is Natim Tetwa, Minister of Sport, Arts and Culture. As the minister responsible to manage the National Commemorative Program on behalf of government, I should like to take this opportunity to remind fellow South Africans that whilst we are still under strict lockdown measures to collectively fight the invisible enemy, coronavirus, otherwise known as COVID-19, this month is also specifically set aside as Freedom Month. We are commemorating this Freedom Day and Freedom Month this year under the theme Solidarity and Triumph of Humanity in These Challenging Times. Of course, the context within which this year's Freedom Month is taking place is very different to the many other Freedom Months before. As has been intimated already, we are in the midst of a pandemic that needs a broader societal collaboration. When we went to the polls on the 27th of April 1994, we collectively embarked on a process of building a united, non-racial, non-sexist, democratic and prosperous society. However, in the process of constructing of this new society, we have encountered many challenges which tested our resilience and strength. South Africans from all walks of life have always demonstrated their determination to overcome the challenges of the day. Whilst freedom guaranteed certain entitlements to us, it also imposes certain corresponding responsibilities and obligations. For an example, as compatriots, we have a responsibility not only to safeguard our own welfare, but more so the welfare of many others around us, especially the vulnerable and marginalized. As we mark Freedom Month, we should collectively acknowledge patriotism displayed by many South Africans in the essential services who continue to make the sacrifices in the efforts to combat the effects of coronavirus. These South Africans continue to live up to the call of our forebears, like Ngungi Mnyane, Sikukuni, Makado, Shaka, Mshweshwe, Ngika, Adam Gok, the Stearman brothers, and many more who, through force of example, taught us never to dishonor the cause of freedom and social justice. Their efforts in combating this deadly virus are highly appreciated, and we applaud you. The security personnel, like true patriots, have ensured peace and calm in our neighborhoods. The medical fraternity continue to provide the necessary care as well as step up efforts on preventative measures. We have also witnessed that same sense of duty from many other trades and occupations in critical services like grocery store worker and petrol attendants. Given these sacrifices, this ought to be a call to all of us in terms of what are we willing to contribute to assist in the battle against this pandemic. It may be something as mundane as foregoing those taken for granted freedoms and social habits, like keeping to the measures on restriction to movement of persons, as well as foregoing of alcohol and cigarette. For the more privileged, we should be looking at overextending ourselves to others, especially those less privileged than we are. Freedom is not only about exercise of rights. Freedom is also about duty in safeguarding the welfare of those less privileged than we are at this time. We will have demonstrated what freedom truly means. Happy Freedom Month.